My name is Alex Roberts. We're at the National Videogame Arcade, and I'm an engineer here. So this is Mission Control. This was my first project when I very first started working here just before we opened last year. It's a bit of a monstrosity. It is a game designed to show people how games are made and give kids the opportunity to interact with the game and change the things in the game whilst they're playing the game. There's two players with Nintendo 64 controllers. And it's a really simple game where you are a character and you have to get pickups and avoid enemies and collect as many and get as many points as you can and beat the other player. But whilst you're doing that, people can draw enemies over here. There is a drawing station where you can draw a picture with a whiteboard marker.
Let's have a picture. Come on, let's have an enemy.
Okay, so we can have an alien with a smiley face, and then we can scan it. Oh, sorry, scan it like that, and it's come up there. Press it again, that's now in the game. So when they start the game, that will be one of the enemies that appears almost immediately. Then around here, you can change all the effects in the game. So we've got whether or not your screen is wrapping or whether you're going to bounce off the sides, the background, turn the liquid mesh on and off. You can change the fonts in the game as well. So there's like a bunch of effects there.
Have you got Comic Sans?
We don't have Comic Sans. Don't worry, it's fine, it's fine. You can change what you're going to be picking up. So one minute you're picking up cherries, and then the next minute you're trying to collect stars or cubes or rings, and the rate at which they spawn. And you can also manually spawn things into the game. So if your friend is near a pickup, you can quickly spawn another one so they can get that as well. Also, on the player, you can choose from our preset selection what your sprite's gonna look like. So at the moment, you're the white character. You can change the color, so you're the red character. So we just changed the color of it, and now we can actually just go, oh, I don't want it to look like that. I'm gonna pick one of the presets. It now says MVA instead. But actually, I don't want it to say that. I'm gonna make it say something else. So on Father's Day, we had Dad was a popular one. So you can change the D, and we got DA. And then we can change that as well. So this is the Novation Launchpad. So it's a MIDI controller, these, that we have rehoused behind in our massive console stuff.
So you literally press the buttons there, that'll turn the pixels on and off, yeah?
Yeah, so you can see that that's now says DVD at the moment. So now it's an alien, and we can just like change what that alien's gonna look like. And you have that for both players. So you've got 3 frames of animation. So you're showing kids a bit about what animation is and kind of just getting them to consider all of these different things. All of these things have to be thought about when you're talking about making a game. So this is like a really clear demonstration of those things. And then you can see if you start playing, the player has gone to manual mode and now I'm in control, whereas player 2 is still being controlled by the AI. There's also some sound effects can be changed around here. So you can change the sound volume. And if we start the game, you can change what track's gonna play while you're playing. And you can also take a photo, or you can draw a picture on a blackboard and then take a photo and it'll become the background of the game.
So how does it work behind the scenes? So we've seen some nice interfaces for people there, but what's going on behind the scenes?
So it is a lot of different things. So the main technology is actually all connected via MIDI, because that's kind of what we knew when we very first started. Now we'd make it an entirely different way, and that is eventually going to be the plan. But like I said, this was kind of the first big project that we did when we got here. So each one of these screens is a Raspberry Pi. So that's just displaying a web page that is being served from a web server, which talks to the Unity game, which is the game running in the background. Then each of the stations is controlled with a Teensy, which is a little bit like an Arduino. And then we've got, obviously, got a PC running the Unity game in the background. Yeah, people really enjoy playing with it, but also it's really nice when people come in and they get why it's there. When people come in and go, oh, yeah, look, you can change all the things and see how a game is put together in that way. And it's like, that's what we were trying to do. So that's really nice.
You must immediately get Dang Beasts. It's been made in Sheffield. It's a kind of drunk jelly babies fighting in a car park. Physics brawler game, a company called Bone Loaf.
This particular server has 4 Titan X graphics cards in it. A Titan X is one of the foremost graphics cards. There are new generation 10